Hello everyone! Welcome to Bruges! Now we're in the Christmas market of the city. It's of course a little bit rainy, but it's Belgium, so you cannot hope that much to have white Christmas at least once. But anyway, it's nice with a lot of lights and shops and lots of all kinds of entertainment. And this year, me, together with three other amazing doll artists, have prepared something very, very special. So, welcome again to my big, special Christmas doll repaint video. So this time we have worked together with three fantastic doll makers, and I'm sure many of you know them already because their works are always amazing and so creative. And I'm talking now about Delightful, Moonlight Jewel and Tamaku. If for some reason you don't know these YouTubers yet, I 100% recommend you to go and to check them. And by the way, can you guess which doll belongs to which artist? Or at least which one of them is mine? Write it in the comment under this video. So if you watch all our four videos and the links to three others you will find here in the description under this video, you will have more than 1 hour of ultimate doll fun. I can promise you. And by the way, don't forget to watch this video till the end, because in the end of the video I will announce the name of my giveaway winner and we will know who will get my Cinderella doll repaint as a Christmas gift. So, let's start repainting! So for my Christmas special, I have decided to take this Jane Bulittle doll and I'm planning to change her completely. Some weeks ago I have already repainted Jane and I thought that my biggest problem with this doll is her intense purple skin color. She has a very cute face mold, but she always stays a purple monster girl. So let's make a Christmas gift for little Jane and give her a complete makeover. In the beginning I remove like always her clothes, shoes and accessories, and then I cut her hair as short as I can with scissors. Then I need to remove her head and make softer the nasty glue that sits inside of her head to be able to pull off the rest of her hair. Many doll artists use hot water for it, and this works for sure. But for me personally, this method seems a little bit too complicated and too dirty. First of all, I just don't want to have water in my studio where I keep dry pastels, fabrics and other stuff that I would really love to keep away from water. So that's why I prefer to use hair dryer on high temperatures. It makes the doll's head very soft and easy to remove, and the glue melts completely inside of her head, and it goes very easy to remove her hair. To remove her makeup, I use pure acetone from a local do-yourself store. I know from the comments that nail polish remover works for some people, but it probably depends on acetone concentration in different kinds of removers. For me personally, the nail polish didn't work. It just smeared all the paint around the whole doll's face, and that was it. So I use pure acetone, and this one works just always. Especially for this doll, I make a blonde glamorous wig using a glue gun and nylon wig hair. There is a more detailed video about wig making on my channel, so you can check it for a complete tutorial. So I have sealed the doll face with 3 layers of Mr. Super Clear sealant, and now the biggest change is coming. We're going to blush her face to change the skin color, and for such a drastic color change I will use the color wheel. I have introduced you the idea of a color wheel in one of my previous videos, so look, her purple skin color is somewhere here on the color chart. So to neutralize it completely, we need to use the opposite color, the one that is in front of our purple color on the wheel. And in our case, it will be the yellow. That's why I first blush the doll face with yellow soft pastels, and you see that the purple color is already immediately gone. And then Then I blush the doll's face like I usually do it with my dolls. First, I add a layer or two of nude pastels. Then I add a layer of orange pastels because her face still looks quite grayish. And a warm orange color will help to remove it and make her skin tone more realistic. Then I take my pencils and draw her eyes. I use Faber-Castell Albrecht Dürer watercolor pencils. And now I'm thinking also about trying watercolor pencils from Derwent, just to see the difference. Maybe I will even purchase a box as a Christmas gift to myself. I always use soft pastels and an eraser to sketch those eyebrows. This is the easiest way for me to draw the eyebrows absolutely symmetric. And this is the favorite part of many of you. But there is nothing to do, the nose must be dark inside, it will give it more realistic dimension. And the line between the lips also must be dark. In this place the two lips touch each other and here automatically lays a shadow. Now let's continue working on your skin tone and it's contouring time. I take taupe color pastels and draw the shadows on her face. The darkest places on the face are the eye crease, the sides of the nose, the corners of her lips, the hairline, and I also always add contouring under her cheekbones, just because it's trendy, you know what I mean. When I'm happy about the intensity of the shadows, I take a mix of red and pink pastels and apply them on top to make the contouring not so much brown. It looks good on dolls and skin tone looks much more alive. And now it's highlights time! Don't be scared that right now her face looks too white because this sealant will eat, I don't know, 80% of the color. So we'll get nicely highlighted forehead and the area under her eyes. Voila, you can see it now. The white is gone. And this you need to know when you work with sealant. If you want to get a nice coverage from the first time, you should use an airbrush and acrylic paint. But you know, I like this old-fashioned handwork. I love pastels and brushes. So and now I take again my pencils and draw the main colors of her face, the eyes, the lips, the eyebrows, and I don't go too much into details with her eyes because I still need to work on her eye makeup. The highlights above her lips are very important, don't forget about them. And now it's eyeshadows time! You know, in real life, with my own face, I do approximately the same like with my dolls. I just adore all those eyeshadows, highlighters, blushers, lipsticks. Some people do makeup to look better, and I do makeup just because I have fun making my eyes look 2 times bigger and wider or giving some dramatic look. Pure fun! If I wasn't a doll artist, I would for sure become a makeup artist. Anyway, it's never too late to combine one with another. So for her eye makeup, I use pink and brown pastels. But the most important part of this step is to put shadows to her eyeline. Eyes always have shadows from the eyelashes. And now it's finally time to work on details and to add some highlights using the white pencil after a layer of dark shadows. Now let's work on the bottom waterline of her eyes, and then I still want to add golden pencil to the eyelids. And since it's Christmas time, I want my doll to shine. And for this I add golden and bronze soft pastels to the most highlighted spots of her face. It looks pretty! And now when her face is almost ready, I take white acrylic paint and add all kinds of accents to her eyes. I absolutely adore this step of repainting. It makes doll eyes immediately so alive. And then with black acrylic paint, I add intensity to the pupils and to the eye line. And now I still need to draw the bottom eyelashes. Now I think I'm happy about her face, and it's time to work on her body. First I sand it with a buffer for nail design, then remove oil with acetone-free nail polish remover, and then I seal it with Mr. Super Clear sealant. When the three layers of the sealant are dry, I take my soft pastels and repeat all the steps I took to change her face tone. And now there are just a couple of steps left. I need to glue the false lashes on and add some glossy varnish to her eyes and lips. And in the end, I still need to sign my work, of course. And are you ready to see the end result? Then you still have to wait for a second, because now it's time to announce the giveaway winner. So I'm opening the randomizer and I see that this time 127 people have participated in my giveaway, and now we will know the name of the winner. Congrats, and I will contact you soon via YouTube messages for more details. And now it's finally time to see the end result. And this year I have made a hot Santa girl. What do you think about her? Please let me know in the comment. more pictures of the dolls you can always find on my Instagram. I'm always happy to see your works made by my tutorials, so you can always feel free to tag me there. And already tomorrow in my new video, I will show you how to make your Santa outfit. So don't forget to check it if your dolls are not ready for Christmas yet. And now let's go back for a moment to Rainy Bruges. So it was my dolly paint. I hope you enjoyed it, and please don't forget to watch 3 other videos from Delightful, from Moonlight Jewel and from Tamako. The links to all these 3 videos will be in the description box under this video. And of course, don't forget to subscribe my channel, to put like under this video. And Merry Christmas, everyone!
Merry Christmas!
So, Merry Christmas from Bruges! And see you in my next videos. Bye! Thank you.